Well, it took 3 years for this probation officer to finally get charged with excessive force on a minor, though the others that were involved should be charged as well.
That violent encounter happened at a juvenile facility 3 years ago. The supervising probation officer was never disciplined for allegedly using excessive force on a minor. That is until now. That officer is now facing criminal charges. A teenager surrounded by probation officers is told to stop resisting. They use force on the 17-year-old, who then screams out for his mom. The disturbing encounter happened at Malibu's Camp Kilpatrick in October of 2020. The video obtained by the LA Times.
Wow, they need this many cops to just deal with one 17-year-old that was just standing there.
Shows five officers pile on the minor, shove him face down onto a bed. It appears he is subdued. Then a supervisor grabs the teen's legs and forces them towards his head.
This is a brutal assault on a child by a person entrusted with his care while he was in custody of the probation department.
On Monday, LA District Attorney.
Wow. And I mean, if this is how they treat, 17-year-olds, how do they treat people younger than that? Because it's not only like 17, 16, and 15-year-olds going to juvie, but, people even younger, as there is a real big, kids to prison pipeline going on in America.
George Gascon announced he is criminally charging supervising probation officer Oscar Cross with one felony count of excessive force.
Even after the minor was handcuffed, Cross continued to hold the minor's leg backward for several more seconds. The youth can be heard continuing to scream and cry in pain.
The teen, now an adult, did not suffer any serious injuries, but officials say the video reflects the reforms needed to hold those who abuse their power accountable.
Supervisor Cross's actions.
What needs to happen is people like these that abuse and assault people while being a probation officer, or police officer, or whatever, they need to be punished like three times as harsh as anybody else. Put this person in prison for the rest of his life.
Should have resulted in an immediate dismissal, not a slap on the wrist, not a covering up of this abusive behavior.
It's unclear.
Yeah, and those who helped cover this up should also be in prison.
If Deputy Cross is still employed, LA County Supervisor Lindsay Horvat says she'll introduce a motion tomorrow to force changes in the juvenile justice system.
If a civilian did this to a cop, that person would have been in jail for a long time. But when a cop abuses a citizen, it's just another day for the duty of a cop to abuse citizens.
We will not tolerate harm, and we will not tolerate child abuse. Not today, not tomorrow, not ever.
And if the probation officer is convicted, he faces up to 3 years in prison.
That's not even long enough, but hopefully somebody deals with them.
Reporting live tonight in the